Hello, and welcome to the first in a series of interviews with artists working on an exciting new international project called Love Beyond Measure. Love Beyond Measure is a Punjabi legend of Sony and Mahiwal, a classic love story in the vein of Cathy and Heathcliff, Romeo and Juliet. The project is run by Wafer Hadley and Alchemy, and it involves artists and venues in Britain and also in India. I'm Daniel Hadley, and joining me today in the studio are Christella Litras, musician and composer, and director of Alchemy, Nima Favea Smith. Good morning to you both.
Good morning.
Christella, you're currently working on a song for this project, and for me, one of the really amazing things about that process is that the words are in place before you come to write the music for those words. Is that an unusual way for making a song for you?
I wouldn't say it was unusual, but normally I begin with a melody, I begin with a rhythmic pattern. I improvise, sit behind my piano or pick the guitar up and, you know, I normally start with the music, start with the rhythm. So to be presented with a poem and have to kind of put this contemporary sound to it, it did challenge me, definitely, because I then had to section it. Normally I think about my intro, think about my verse, my chorus, my second verse, that whole kind of formula of songwriting, but it wasn't presented to me like that, so I had to make it work. And I could give you an example of
yes,
what I mean.
Yeah, do. That would be lovely.
I do the first section of Song of Rope, which goes, rope, bamboo, or jungle vine, age, middling, or fine, the east, the west, the north, the south, age old and never new, I the earth entwine. It ends there, but then I had to just add that last line, just repeat it, so musically it makes sense. I the earth entwine. And it goes on, but that's all you get in.
Fantastic, thank you very much. So Nima, you write the words, you send them to Christella, and back comes this fully formed song. How does that feel?
Well, it is not quite as organized as that on my part, I have to say. I certainly approached her in a spirit of both naivety and ignorance. So it is quite interesting to hear what Christella had to say. Because the poem was just a poem. I didn't think of verse one, chorus, verse two, chorus, outro. You know, I didn't think of any of that. And it's only when Christella put it to music and it came back and I thought, my God, this is so magical. And of course, the poor girl had to do a lot of work on this to create this bit of alchemy.
Yeah, but for me, as I was reciting the poems, you find the sound in the poetry and the rhythm just jumps out at you. And as a musician, I was able to kind of apply that to my instrument. So that's where I began.
Great. And these songs are available to download, I think, on the Alchemy website, is that right?
Yes, absolutely.
Okay, great. So another thing that strikes me about this project is all the contrasts within it. I think, you know, even in the song that you're making together, we're looking at a very old story and hearing a more contemporary sound. Is that something that's typical of the project? And is it something that is typical of this time and place that we're in, all those contrasts?
I think it is typical of the project and it is typical of the time and place, and maybe I'm wrong, but I'd also say there's something uniquely British about it. The fact that we are able to do that and to do it with a certain degree of ease. The region and the country, I would say, fizzes with talent. And it's nice that these things happen quite organically and naturally. And I don't think this would have been as easy in many other countries.
And on that note, I was exposed to artistic collaboration from years ago, as you know, through Geraldine Connor.
Absolutely.
And obviously based in Yorkshire, she had this a magic and passion to bring together different art forms. So what you said about just being natural and allowing it to just take place organically and have that raw kind of vibe, you can't beat that.
And it is true that Geraldine brought us together through Carnival Messiah. And Geraldine, of course, was a founder board member of Alchemy. Mm-hmm. So there are all kinds of lovely synergies there.
Yeah.
I think that's another feature of this project, isn't it? That it brings together artists from very different backgrounds. How do you make that work? Maybe I could ask you that, Christella. How does a collaboration between two artists work, or more than two artists?
Well, I know that I'm a composer, I'm a singer, so I'm going to focus on that. I'm not going to try and dance. I'm not going to try and recite poetry. So I just think we have to stick to our art form and appreciate the other side, the other forms that take place. So you just have to enjoy it, and you have to be truthful in expressing. I normally take it from a spiritual point of view as well, and I just have to be honest. I can't pretend when it comes to expressing myself and collaborating. I think through Carnival Messiah, I was really fortunate to work with dancers, work with poets, and you know, it just happens. I just think you have to love what you do and appreciate that workspace. And I think that when you allow that flow to take place, you have to understand something great is going to happen between people and not just one person. So that's what I think.
Do you have a final thought on that, Nina?
Yes, actually, because I learned very early on that if we brought artists together in a creative space, even if they didn't know one another, all kinds of creative generosity flowed from that. And we've done this time and again, and I'm always astonished at the end result. There's trust, there's generosity, and of course, immense talent going into it.
Well, I'm sure we're all wishing the project all the best in that aspect and all its other aspects in the following months.
Thank you.
Brilliant. Love Beyond Measure begins in March of this year. So you can follow all the progress from the Alchemy website. Check your email, check social media for other videos coming up as part of this project. And I think that all that is left to say really from us all in the studio today is thank you very much for watching, and keep your eye on this project. Thank you.
Thank you, Dan.
Thank you.